Hello everyone. Today we will start the new topic, non-food crops. In previous class we discussed about the some important food crops and the crops other than food, right? So first crop is rubber. Rubber is an equatorial plant, means that we can grow in the equatorial area, the area which is near the equator. It requires more than 200 cm rainfall and the temperature should be above 25 degree Celsius. It is an important industrial raw material. So student, we use so many products that are made by rubber. So this is the main important raw material for the industries. Some important states in India that grow the rubber are Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Andaman Nicobar and Garo Hills in Meghalaya. Beta, in Meghalaya we have the three important hills, Garo, Khasi and Jayantia, right? India is the fifth largest producer of rubber and the first one is Thailand, okay? Thailand is the largest producer of rubber. Next one is cotton. After rubber we have the important crop, non-food crop, that is cotton. India is the original home of the cotton plant. You should understand some points. India is the original home, means in the world the first source of cotton found only in India during the Harappan civilization. Okay, it grows well in black soil. Black soil is also known as the cotton soil because black soil is the largest, yeah, you can say black soil is the more fertile for the cotton crop. That's why the black soil is known as the cotton soil also. It requires high temperature and light rainfall. And out of 365 days, it requires 300 days the sunlight. Okay, it is a kharif crop and the major states are Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh, right? Next one is jute. Jute is a natural fiber. It is also known as golden fiber, right? Due to its color, it is in brown color, that's why it is known as a golden fiber. It is the cheapest vegetable fiber after cotton, right? It is the second cheapest vegetable fiber after cotton, right? Due to its global consumption, production and availability, right? It has high tensile strength. Tensile strength means we can spread this one in a large part. Okay, iski jo spread hone ki power hai wo jyada hai. Okay, the next one is jute fiber is 100% biodegradable and recyclable and thus environmentally friendly, means आपका जो जूट है वो 100% बायोडिग्रेडेबल है और रिसाइक्लेबल है, राइट? एंड इन इंडिया वेस्ट बंगाल इज द लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ जूट एंड यू कैन से इंडिया इज द लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ जूट इन द वर्ल्ड फॉलोड बाय बांग्लादेश, ओके? एंड नाउडेज जूट इज द मेन natural fiber as compared to the others. Next one is fiber crops. Fiber crops like cotton, jute, hemp, these are the natural fibers. Okay. The first three are, we have the four main fiber crops like cotton, jute, hemp and natural silk. Right, कॉटन जूट हम दीज आर ड्राइड फ्रॉम द क्रॉप्स, हम उनको उनके लिए क्रॉप्स ग्रो करते हैं सॉइल में, देन हम उनको ऑब्टेन करते हैं, राइट। सिल्क इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द कोकोन्स, इसके लिए हमें सिल्क वर्म चाहिए जिससे हमें सिल्क मिलता है, राइट, नेचुरल सिल्क मिलता है। एंड द रियरिंग ऑफ सिल्क वर्म फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सिल्क फाइबर इज नोन एज सेरिकल्चर। ओके, सिल्क वर्म की जो हम एग्रीकल्चर करते हैं, सिल्क वर्म का जो रियरिंग होता है उसको बोलते हैं सेरिकल्चर। नेक्स्ट वन इज दीज आर सम पिक्चर्स रिलेटेड टू द नेचुरल फाइबर, कॉटन, दिस इज हम, दिस इज जूट, सॉरी जूट, एंड दिस इज हम, राइट। आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड द पॉइंट्स, यू अंडरस्टैंड द नॉन फूड क्रॉप्स एंड देयर इम्पोर्टेंस इन देयर इन आर लाइफ। थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे।